गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी लेक्चर ऑन इंट्रानेटल केयर एंड पोस्टनेटल केयर। व्हाट इज इंट्रानेटल केयर? इट कैन बी डिफाइंड एज केयर टेकन ड्यूरिंग द डिलीवरी। एम्स ऑफ गुड इंट्रानेटल केयर, दे आर थरो एसेप्सिस, दिस वी विल सी इन फर्दर स्लाइड, डिलीवरी विद मिनिमम इंजुरीज टू द इन्फेंट एंड मदर, रेडीनेस to deal with complications such as prolonged labor, antepartum hemorrhage, convulsions, malpresentation, cord prolapse, etc. Care of baby at delivery, resuscitation, care of the cord, care of the eyes, etc. As I have told you in previous slide regarding thorough asepsis, during safe, to conduct a safe delivery, you should consider these 5 C's. They are clean surface, clean hand, clean cord cut, clean tie, and clean stump. Clean surface, where delivery is going to be conducted. Clean hands, the birth attender who is conducting the delivery. Then clean cord, blade or instrument which is used to cut the cord, they should be clean. Then clean cord tie, the thread which is used to tie the umbilical cord, and then clean cord stump. There should not be any application to the cord. In the rural settings, in some communities, they have an habit of applying cow dung to the stump, which leads to infection.
Domiciliary care. Mother with normal obstetric history may be advised to have their confinement in their own homes, provided the home conditions are satisfactory. In such cases, delivery may be conducted by female health worker or trained daya. This is known as domiciliary midwifery service.
We will see some advantages and disadvantages of domiciliary midwifery service. Advantages are, mother delivers in the familiar surrounding, removes fear associated with delivery in hospital. Next, the chances of cross infection are fewer at home than in hospital. Mother is able to keep an eye on her children and domestic affairs, thus ease her mental tension. And disadvantages are, mother may have less medical and nursing supervision than hospital, less rest, mother may resume her domestic duties too soon, her diet may be neglected. Danger signals. What are these danger signals? Since 72% of Indian population lives in rural areas, as health facilities are not adequate, so most of the deliveries takes place in home with the help of female health worker or trained dayas. Domiciliary outreach is a major component of intranatal health care. So the female health worker or dayas should adequately train to recognize the danger signals during labor so that they can refer the patient to the higher centers. The danger signals are sluggish pain or no pain after rupture of membrane, good pain for an hour after rupture of membrane but no progress, prolapse of cord or hand, meconium stain liquor or slow, irregular or excessive fast fetal heart, excessive bleeding during labor, collapse during labor, placenta not separated within half an hour after delivery, postpartum hemorrhage or collapse, temperature of 38 degrees Celsius or over during labor.
Institutional care. About 1% of deliveries tend to be abnormal and 4% difficult, which requires the service of doctor. Institutional care is recommended for all high-risk cases and where home conditions are not suitable.
The next aspect is rooming in. What is rooming in? Keeping baby's crib by the side of the mother's bed. It gives opportunity to mother to know her baby. It allows the fear in the mother's mind that the baby is not misplaced in the central nursery. It builds up her self-confidence. Postnatal care. What is postnatal care? It can be defined as care of the mother and the newborn after delivery is known as postnatal care. Broadly, it falls into two areas. First one, care of the mother and care of the newborn. Care of the mother is the responsibility of obstetrician and care of the newborn is combined responsibility of obstetrician and pediatrician. This combined area of responsibility is known as perinatology. Care of the mother. Objectives are to prevent complication of postpartum period, restoration of mother to optimum health, check adequacy of breastfeeding, provide family planning services, provide basic health education to mother and family. Complications. Complications of postnatal care are puerperal sepsis, secondary hemorrhage, thrombophlebitis, and other complications. In others, they are urinary tract infection and mastitis. First, we will see puerperal sepsis. Puerperal sepsis is an infection of genital tract within 3 weeks. It is the most commonest complication during postnatal period. It is characterized by rising temperature and pulse rate, foul smelling lochia, pain and tenderness in lower abdomen. It can be prevented by maintaining asepsis before and after delivery. The second complication is thrombophlebitis, infection of veins of legs associated with varicose vein. Secondary hemorrhage, bleeding from vagina from 6 hours to 6 weeks. In others, they are urinary tract infection and mastitis. Restoration of mother to optimum health. It is the second objective of postnatal care. It can be divided into physical, psychological, and social. Further, physical can be subdivided into postnatal examination, anemia, nutrition, and postnatal exercise. Postnatal examination. Soon after delivery, the health checkup must be frequent, that is, twice a day during the first 3 days and subsequently once a day till the umbilical cord drops off. At each of these examinations, the female health worker should check for temperature, pulse and respiration, examine the breast, check for progress of normal involution of uterus, examine lochia for any abnormalities, check urine and bowel, and advise on perineal toilet including care of stitches. At the end of 6 weeks, an examination is necessary to check up involution of uterus, which should be completed by then. Further visits should be done once a month during first 6 months and then after once in 2 or 3 months till the end of 1 year. In rural areas, only limited postnatal care is possible. Efforts should be taken by female health workers to give at least 3 to 6 postnatal visits. The common condition found on examination during the late postnatal period are subinvolution of uterus, retroverted uterus, prolapse of uterus, and cervicitis. Postnatal examination gives an opportunity to detect and correct these defects.
Anemia. Routine hemoglobin examination should be done during postnatal visits, and when anemia is detected, early treatment should be started. In some cases, it may be necessary to continue the treatment for a year or more. Nutrition. Even though the mother is malnourished, she has enough milk to feed her baby, but at the cost of her health. the woman has to prepare a nutritious meal with a low budget. Postnatal exercises are necessary to bring the stretched abdominal and pelvic muscle back to normal. Psychological. The mother has fear of delivery, which needs proper prenatal education. She feels timid and insecure for the baby, which needs family support, especially from husband. Postnatal psychosis is precipitated at delivery, but it is uncommon. Then, social. Along with birth proper nurturing in a wholesome family environment is necessary. Check adequacy of breastfeeding. Exclusive breastfeeding for 6 months, 400 to 600 milliliter per day. Supplementary weaning food after 6 months. Family planning, postpartum sterilization, that is on second day of delivery, IUDs, conventional contraceptives, progesterone only pill. Basic health education, hygiene, nutrition, pregnancy spacing, importance of health checkup and birth registration. RMN CH plus A strategy. This will be taught in another lecture, but I will be telling some important points regarding pregnancy and reproduction. Continuum of care. Places where care is provided, that is pregnancy, birth, newborn, childhood, adolescent and pre-pregnancy. Pregnancy and childbirth. Priority interventions. Preventive use of folic acid in periconception period, delivery of antenatal care package and tracking of high-risk pregnancies. Skilled obstetric care, immediate essential newborn care and resuscitation, emergency obstetric and newborn care, postpartum care for mother and newborn, postpartum IUCDs and sterilization, implementation of PC and PNDT Act, preventive use of folic acid in periconception period, community-based interventions, promoting use of folic acid in planned pregnancies for 3 months before and 3 months after conception, pre-pregnancy checkups with one pre-pregnancy visit to couples planning pregnancy should be included in RM and CH plus A in states where large number of pregnancies are planned. ASHA be given intensives to counsel couple to delay first birth and space two births. Antenatal care package and tracking of high-risk pregnancies. ANC package is delivered at community outreach and health facility level. Timely identification of complications and appropriate referral. Mother and child tracking system. Mechanism that enables service providers to follow up women and program managers to monitor service delivery. Skilled obstetric care and essential newborn care and resuscitation. Delivery points to be prioritized for allocation of resources. Saturation of delivery points with skilled birth attendant. Janani Suraksha Yojana. Janani Shishu Suraksha Karyakram. Navjat Shishu Suraksha Karyakram. Janani Suraksha Yojana JSY. launched on 12th April 2005 under NRHM. That is, objectives of this are to reduce maternal and neonatal mortality by promoting institutional deliveries, ASHA as the link between government and the poor, integrates the benefit of cash assistance with institutional care during antenatal delivery and immediate postpartum care. Divisions of states, low performing states and high performing states. Low performing states, less than 25% institutional deliveries, and high performing states, more than 25% institutional delivery. Eligibility for cash assistance. Low performing state, all women delivering in government health centers and accredited private institution. In high performing state, BPL women more than 19 years of age, SC and ST pregnant women. Limitation of cash assistance. In low performing state, all birth gets the benefit. In high performing state, benefits is only up to 2 live births. Pregnant women should have a BPL certificate in high performing state. ASHA must assist in obtaining necessary certifications. In cases BPL card have not been issued, states and union territories should formulate an simple criteria for certification of the poor and needy, expected mother's family by empowering the Gram Pradhan or ward member. In rural areas, low performing state, mother's package is 1400 and ASHA's package is 600, total 2000 rupees. In high performing state, mother's package is 700 and ASHA's package is 600, total 1300 rupees. In urban areas, low performing state, mother's package is 1000 and ASHA's package is 400, total 1400 rupees. And in low performing state, in high performing state, mother's package is 600 and ASHA's package is 400, total 1000 rupees are given. Payment to the beneficiary must be made at the institution itself in one go. If beneficiary opts to deliver in private institution, payment of at least 3/4 amount to be done in one go. ASHA package is not given. ASHA package given to ASHA after postnatal visit and when baby is given BCG. Balance amount given to ASHA and the institutional itself, at the institutional itself. Women delivering at home are given cash assistance of rupees 500 irrespective of parity under NMBS. State and district authorities gives rupees 10,000 and 5,000 to ANM in low performing state and high performing state respective, kept in joint account of ANM and Gram Pradhan. Management of caesarean section and obstetric complication under JSY. PSCs, FRUs, CHCs will provide services free of cost. Where government specialized are not available, assistance of rupees 1500 can be utilized to hire services of private sector specialties. If private specialties not available, services of specialists from other government setups can be utilized. Rupees 1500 can be used to pay honorarium or cover transport expenses. Panel of such doctor must be prepared beforehand. Janani Shishu Suraksha Karyakram JSSK. It was launched on 1st June 2011. Aim to reduce out-of-pocket expenses related to maternal and newborn care. All pregnant women delivering in public health institution to have absolutely free and no expense delivery, including caesarean section, free drugs, consumables, diet, diagnostics, and blood transfusion and transport, extended to sick newborns up to 30 days after birth. Navjat Shishu Suraksha Karyakram (NSSK). It was launched on 15 September 2009 to train healthcare providers, their doctors and ANM at district hospital, CHCs, PSCs in management of resuscitation, prevention of infection, hypothermia and treatment, management and early initiation of breastfeeding of newborns. Establish newborn care corner at delivery point and linkage with SNCU. Saturation of delivery point with skilled birth attendants and NSSK trained personnel is a priority. Emergency obstetric and newborn care. Delivery points at subcenters and PSCs. 24/7 emergency service at CSCs. Maternal and child health wings, that is 30, 50, 100 bedded. Established at high case load facilities to provide quality service and ensure 48 hour stay at the facility. Multi-skilling of doctors in public health system. 18 weeks training of MBBS doctors in life-saving anesthetic skills. 16 weeks training in obstetric management skills with LSCS. 10 days training of medical officer in basic emergency obstetric care. 3 weeks training in skilled birth attendants for ANM, LHV and staff nurse. Now, postpartum care for mother and baby. 48 hours of stay at health facility is mandatory in case of institutional delivery. Breastfeeding and hypothermia needed to be addressed during this period. Postpartum depression and psychosis needed to be addressed through professional involvement. Postpartum IUCDs insertion and sterilization. Placement of trained providers for postpartum IUCDs insertion at district and sub-district hospital. Training of medical officers in mini lab for postpartum sterilization. RMNCH counselors at public sector health facilities to be generate awareness. Increased demand for RMNCH services and motivate women to adopt modern family planning methods. Implementation of PCPNDT Act. Prohibition of sex selection and regulation of prenatal diagnostic techniques for detecting abnormalities and preventing misuse of sex determination leading to female feticides. Formation of dedicated preconception and prenatal diagnostic techniques cell at state and district level. Strengthening of human resources. Establishing appropriate infrastructure at all levels. Reproductive health. Priority intervention under RMNCH A+. Community-based promotion and delivery of contraceptives. Promotion of spacing methods. Sterilization services. Comprehensive abortion care. Preventive and management of sexual transmitted and reproductive infection. Community-based doorstep distribution of contraceptives. Charges taken by the ASHAs from beneficiaries. Contraceptives. Package of 3 condoms, 1 rupees. A cycle of OC pill, 1 rupees. A package of emergency contraceptive pills, 2 rupees. Among OC pills, only combined pill is available under the program. Promotion of space स्पेसिंग मेथड्स, इंटरवल IUCDs, की मेजर्स, इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ न्यू IUCDs ऑफ 5 ईयर ड्यूरेशन, पोस्ट डिलीवरी IUCD इंसर्शन, काउंसलर्स इन डिस्ट्रिक्ट हॉस्पिटल्स एंड हाई caseload facilities, training of health personnel in IUCDs, insertion at all level of health facilities, ensuring the availability of IUCDs 380A and mixed day service and fixed day services at all facilities. Sterilization services. Important steps: promotion of non-scalpel vasectomy for increasing male participation, emphasis on mini-lap tubectomy services, accreditation of private providers and NGOs for service delivery, increasing the pool of training service providers, compensation scheme for sterilization acceptors, providers for loss of wages to the beneficiaries and payment made to the service providers, family planning insurance scheme. Launched in November 2005 for acceptors of sterilization and indemnity insurance covered for doctors, health facilities performing sterilization procedures in both government and accredited private NGOs, corporate health facilities. For acceptors, ₹25,000 to 30,000 for sterilization failure and other benefits. For doctor, again, the claim arising out of failure of sterilization death or medical complications resulting up to a maximum amount of 2 lakh per doctor or health facility. Comprehensive abortion care. At PSCs and CSCs or sub-district level, if the trained manpower is not available, then safe motherhood consultant can be hired to conduct MTPs and paid ₹800 per day visit. Pregnancy testing kits. Nischay for early detection of pregnancy and provide and provision of safe abortion and services. Thank you.